They laid him in an office of the post, and soldiers, forming in a hollow square, held back the people. Silence deepened there. A little while, it seemed the man was dead. He lay so still. The West no longer bled. Among the crowd, the dust began to creep. Then suddenly, as startled out of sleep by some old dream-remembered night alarm, he strove to shout, half rose upon an arm, and glared about him in the lamp-lit place. The flare across the ashes of his face went out. He spoke, and leaning where he lay, men strained to gather what he strove to say. So hard, the panting labor of his words. I had my village and my pony herds on Powder, where the land was all my own. I only wanted to be let alone. I did not want to fight. The gray fox sent his soldiers. We were poorer when they went. Our babies died, for many lodges burned and it was cold. We hoped again and turned our faces westward. It was just the same out yonder on the Rosebud. Gray fox came. The dust his soldiers made was high and long. I fought him and whipped him. Was it wrong to drive him back? That country was my own. I only wanted to be let alone. I did not want to see my people die. They say I murdered long hair. That's Custer. They say I murdered long hair, and they lie. His people came to kill us, and they died. He choked and shivered, staring hungry-eyed, as though to make the most of little light. Then, like a child that feels the clutching night and cries the wilder, deeming it in vain, he raised a voice made lyrical with pain and terror of a thing about to be. I want to see you, Father. Come to me. I want to see you, Mother. O'er and o'er his cry assailed the darkness at the door, and from the gloom beyond the hollow square of soldiers quavered voices of despair. We cannot come. They will not let us come. But when at length the lyric voice was dumb, and Crazy Horse was nothing but a name, there was a little withered woman came behind a bent old man. Their eyes were dim. They sat beside the boy and fondled him, remembering the little dreams he knew, the little names he knew before the great dream took him, and he grew to be so mighty. And the woman pressed the hand that men had feared against her breast, and swayed and sang a little sleepy song. Out yonder in the village all night long, there was a sound of mourning in the dark. And when the morning heard the meadowlark, the last great Sioux rode silently away. Before the pony drag on which he lay, an old man tottered, bowed above the bier. A little wrinkled woman kept the rear, without a sound and nothing in her eyes. Who knows the crumbling summit where he lies, alone among the badlands? Coyotes prowl about it, and the voices of the owl assume the day-long sorrow of the crows. These many grasses and these many snows.